Were you aware of such successful
evening? No, I wasn't. I'm surprised at the success anywhere beyond England, because this fixation with aging spinsters and deviant religious people, killing scores of people in the woodlands and the fields of Buckinghamshire, it seems to be a particularly English preoccupation. But it has, as it were, translated and been transported and deported to all the countries in the world. Midsomer Murders, as a brand, sells to something like 209, 210 countries. I didn't know there were as many countries as that in the world, but there are, apparently. And what the Japanese make of it, I don't know. But I do know that the Russians, I get a lot of correspondence from Russia, they think it's some kind of documentary. They think that's the way we live in the decadent capital West, and we kill a lot of people. The French like it because they think they're well, like Jean Gabin on that day, and they think it's some kind of negro. There's a little story I'd like to tell you about the French series. They dub it over there in France, and they dub it, of course, into French. And I've got a pretty ordinary voice, and a pretty ordinary kind of guy, actually. But the man who dubs me in French is a man called Hervé, and Hervé is just bloody brilliant, because he makes me sound like the sexiest, most spiritual, most intellectual, wisest being that God ever put breath into. And the French think it's me. It ain't, it's Hervé. And I'm going to send him some money soon.